Which cash inflow would you change? Would you discount this guy or this guy? Which one would you do? It's always an interesting question, because one of the disadvantages, it doesn't take time and money. And accountants don't. You read any textbook, they don't give an example of it. But like payback period, this can be sorted. This can be changed. It can be sorted. Very possible that more than one project may have the same or similar AR. You may have three phones. Shh, shh, shh. Why? What's going on? You may have same 39% with A, B, and C project. Right? Different cash flows, but after tax and all that, you may end up with three, four projects with the same or very similar. Then which one do you pick? But that could be a problem with any one of them. Payback period also. You could have three projects giving back payback, similar payback period, discounted payback period. Net present value, three of them could be very close to each other. Difference of only few pounds here and there. Then which one do you pick? Or they're identical. But the biggest problem over here is, when does the firm stop counting the net income? When do you, what is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9? When do you stop counting? Just like payback period, when do you stop counting? Discounted payback period or payback period? When do you stop saying, I want the money back in 2 years or 3 years? When do you stop counting here? And if you use discounted, and that could be a very interesting question. Well, if you use discounted, which one do you discount? Which one do you discount? Because these are all in the future. You have not paid any tax yet. No tax has been paid yet. Okay, think about that. I'll see you tomorrow.